Welcome everyone back to the Boulevard. You're here with me, One Man Jack. And this is quite possibly one of my favorite video games to ever exist. Not because it's the best to play, or because it's got like the best graphics, or because it's awesome, epic, action-packed adventure, but because this game achieves something that is very, very difficult to do, but is something that can only be accomplished with video games. And I'm not gonna say what that is. Instead of that, we're just gonna play through it. And we're gonna see exactly how this goes. I'll likely go back and play Solarmax 1 at some point. We're gonna start with 2 because I found it first. So this game, pretty simple. You have planets that you colonize with your spaceships, and you send them to go invade other people. And then you wait, you capture a new planet, and all is good with the world. Excuse me, needed a chug of that healthy grape juice. Mission number 2, we have an enemy. The enemy wants to colonize the same planet, and it has come to war. So you've got the slider at the bottom to determine how much of your fleet you send when you click go. We're gonna leave this at about 80, and we'll call it 85. We're probably not going to move it very much for the rest of the game, because like you don't really ever want to send an entire fleet, because then a planet's unguarded. But I'm talking too much. This is a quiet, relaxed game. Let's just listen and watch. So we found an enemy and we fought with them. And the war continues. We want what they have, and they want what we have. It's a story of... It's the age-old story of humanity, always seeking to conquer something else. This is going to be a quieter video, in case that wasn't already apparent, because... Just listen to that piano. Like, everyone knows this by now, I am a sucker for a good music track. And even more than that, I am a sucker for the piano, and I am a sucker for the violin. Victory. Our armies are courageous, and though our enemies are many, we win the day. We notice a population maximum at the top. So it seems our planets can only support a certain amount of life. We're going to abandon that top one for now. And we can get more ships by capturing more planets. Sensible enough. And all planets generate new ships if you are not at the population maximum. Alright. For the record, I don't think this is the first game to use this kind of click-and-drag send fleets gameplay formats. I want to say the first I ever saw was Phage, which was the same kind of mechanic, but you were bacteria, and you were No, you were cells sending individual bacteria, or viruses, actually. Yeah, it would have been viruses to go infect other cells. And that game worked quite well. I'll probably be going there, but that game can't quite do what this game does. And the effect might be... I wonder who in the comments is going to notice what it is specifically that I like about this game. It's not the soundtrack. The soundtrack helps, of course. And the effect, as a hint, the effect is probably ruined by my narration of the events. But we'll get there. I'll probably give a full explanation at the end of the game. But for right now, the war escalates. Wherever we go, our enemies follow. We crush them mercilessly, invading their system, conquering what is theirs. Or sometimes making a tactical withdrawal, if that's the best option. The enemy invades us, but fighting on our home turf, we easily destroy them. An enemy planet that runs out of ships can no longer produce more ships if you have a fleet there to subjugate them. Our fleets are heroic, bold. We continue the war. We continue our victory. Evenly matched, even a single ship can turn the tide of the battle. Our conquest continues. No victory too great, no planet unpillaged. We thirst for more, evermore. I should just shut up and play. I was like, on one hand, I feel like me shutting up would ruin the entire point of a Let's Play, because if you wanted to just see the graphics, you could go play the game yourself, but at the same time, I don't want to say anything because... I'm not making any sense. You know what? That's okay. I don't have to be smart all the time. This. Some new technology blocks our fleet's advance. Some sort of signal? It interrupts our fleets. It prevents them from traveling across that section of space. I don't know. I'm not 100% sure how they've accomplished it, but it is some technology clearly remnant of a lost civilization. Who were they to leave behind such massive, monumental constructs? Stop being fancy. This, I think, might be one of the places where this game falls apart. When you have an enemy that is smart enough to run away, but not smart enough to admit defeat. There we go. This is odd. The constructs appear to be guarding something, but there's nothing there. Just an empty patch of space. Locked off forever. Crafty, but we had the upper hand. Now we meet them on even footing. What happens now? We are merciless. We strike directly for their homeworld. Directly for where they are strongest. And in this manner they fall. Ruthlessness is our weapon, and it serves us well. Yeah, I fucked up there. Meant to capture that planet. Oh, this isn't gonna end well. Get out. Leave. Oh wait, they successfully captured that? Well shit. Nope, it's too late now. I might have just royally... Oh, wait, no. Okay. This is a fight I can win. Mainly by taking advantage of the fact that fighting on the home field advantage means you always get fresh ships. And that is enough. They are not gonna make this easy on me, though. here the struggle comes to a culmination. Artifact left behind? What purpose does it serve? A warp gate? Who could have built such a marvel that we've never seen one before? What mighty empire constructed such engineering and then vanished? This is probably going to be the most boring Let's Play ever, and I apologize for that. Thank you. See, like, this is what I mean when I say an AI that's smart enough to run away, but not smart enough to accept defeat. So we're just gonna have to... Just stop. Die, why don't you? See, like that. If you bring your fleets to bear, they run away. Just gotta, like, fight in bad battles on purpose. Because, like, you just have to slowly weather them down. Maybe just trick them into thinking they have a chance of victory when really they don't. I don't know. All I know is that chasing this single fleet back and forth is really starting to get annoying. Oh, they went for the warp gate this time. Okay. I'm fine with- you sorry sack of shit. No, why? Stop. Just fucking die. You vex me, game. Like, I'm not gonna lose, but that doesn't mean they're gonna make winning easy. There we go. Look long enough. Okay. What's this? Another construct. This one unfamiliar to us. What function does it serve? Oh god, it's a turret. Rages on. Us against them. as our conquests grew, so too did our thirst. We yearned for more, for everything. We would crush this enemy beneath our heel. We would become supreme masters of the universe. That sounds really cheesy. Challenge. A turret locked off from the rest of the battlefield. The force we sent was stronger. The turret fell to us. I really do need. I need to either, like, talk consistently or shut the fuck up. I feel like I'm trying to do both, and it's not working. Thank you. Through might and mischief, we are victorious. This game was. Oh well. That's fine. Whoop. That's not. Screaming, not a lot of action. There will be plenty of screaming later. Believe me, I can assure you there will be plenty of games for you to scream at. Don't think I can think of very many games I can just... cheesing this level, but I'm in a mood to get things done quickly. What's this? We find some other enemy among the stars. Who are they? Whose side will they choose in this conflict? Defend our own. Let them attack each other if they so wish. We take what's ours, and a little bit more. Looking good for the home team here. Nope. This might also be considered cheesing this level. I don't care. No, or orange, why, you fuck. Red's gonna win now. It's like, this level especially, because it's so small, it comes down to more about psychology and trying to bid orange against red than it is about actual tactics, because there's not much you can do here. You guys see everything that I'm working with. And everything that I'm working with is not a lot. If I can just capture three planets. Usually if you can get three planets captured here, you're golden. Orange will be too busy taking out red to stop me from doing this. Yes, I am burning my men purely to stall for time. They will be remembered. Or maybe they won't. Only took me, what, three tries? Here we go. Who'd have thought the universe would be so crammed for elbow room? No, Red, kindly fuck off. I'll just take your planet. Saw that coming. Bastards collectively fuck off. You know what? Time to do something stupid. I'm gonna mess with affairs that are none of my business. Red and Orange have shown no reluctance to do the same to me, so I'm just gonna send some boys over, see if I can't mess them up a little. You can take that warp portal. It's not nearly as important as having a whole lot of ships. And that's what I have right now. A whole lot of ships. Patience. See, like, this is the thing. At this point, I own 6 of the 8 planets. That means I have 6 planets producing ships, and he has 2. Realistically, unless I throw my hands in the air and give up, there is no victory for him. But he's gonna make me work for it, because these AI don't know how to do anything except for fuck around. You'll also notice that the tempo of the music has changed. This isn't about peaceful space exploration anymore. This isn't about beating out a single enemy in a competition to colonize. This is a war hymn. This is music that you play when you go to battle. This is music fit for crushing those who oppose you. Fitting in a way. I lost that. Oh, that's why I lost that. I should just let them... It would only be polite for me to let them settle their squabbles before I try and intervene, right? This one fleet win by virtue of capturing planets faster than the enemy can fly. Here is where we make our stand. Nope, that was the wrong play. This might also be the wrong play, but I am fond of these turrets, you know. My lord, Orange is doing quite well for himself over there. Hopefully my enemies can buy me enough time to finish conquering this quadrant. It does not look like they were successful in purchasing time for me. So I remember why it was that I liked to send 95%, because sending any less than 100 just means the enemy will crush whatever garrison you leave behind, but sending everything means you can't blockade the ports and the enemy gets to produce more ships. So if you only leave a few, then they can just, even one ship can blockade a port and prevent a planet from producing more. So you'll need a little bit. We're gonna storm that turret. I want this turret. Planet by planet, system by system, their empires fell. But what is this? Some new power? Hurry, men. Activate it. Let us see what wonders await. Factory. Mothership. Look at that thing demolish them as they fly past. I wonder if they'll let us get away with the exact same tactic. Somehow I don't think they will, but I want to try. Nope, they did not. So instead, we're gonna... No, Red, you son of a... That was my idea, Red! You can't do that! Ah, the mothership is ours. Victory is all but assured. Thank you. Man, this game is significantly longer than I remember. Not a bad thing, though. Risky gambit, but a successful one. Orange got too much power too quickly. No, that. Oh my gosh. Okay, we're gonna try this again, but with less bad. No, Orange, please, why? Oh my gosh. See, this is why we can't have nice things. Why? I don't even care about my home planet. Take it. Fuck. That's another game lost. Maybe I'm going for that mothership too early. I mean, it is super ultra mega powerful, but maybe just having a raw amount of ships would be better in this case. See, at this point, Orange, like, there's nothing I can do to stop Orange. He's just got too much. Orange, you are not going to be able to capture that station in time. I'm not even remotely worried about that. But look at this! While I'm trying to get my shit sorted, Red has conquered everything. Why? Because Orange went, you know what? Fuck it, I'm going this way. This is not going well. Why am I even still recording this? Seriously. This just might be it. I've got a solid foothold in the west. Red is still fighting Orange in the east. God. Orange is at his population cap. He can't build any more ships, I don't think. And he has assaulted my foundry. That might turn out to be... Yeah, that was a mistake, because I have the turret to back it up. So instead of attacking his foundry, like a dum-dum, I'm gonna attack everything else. And maybe I'll- nope, not his foundry. That's a bad plan. Now I have a hold of his turret. Slow time down, back down a little bit. That was difficult. Really should have made this a two-part. This might even, you know, no, this is going straight to the junk pile. There's just no denying. gonna slow this back down. Start applying some proper actual tactics. Because Red is actually doing quite well for himself. Quite well indeed. As the fourth foundry fell, his fate was written. In this game, there can be only one victor. What is this? Another construct, this one fiercely guarded by automations. Mindless machines, guarding something. What do they protect? What secrets would this hold? Get wrecked trying to find out. So Red just did what I tried to do, except he did a lot better. Unlock what secrets lay buried here. We will claim their power as our own. Oh. What is this? Yes. Your power unto me. Wait. What is happening? Thank you. How? That level up good. Fight, men. Fight this abominable scourge. Go quietly unto the dark. We have repelled this darkness, but for how long? To what end? Our petty wars continue. Nightmare turned back. Forgotten. Now. Notice again, before it faded out, that the music had changed again. No longer roaring and triumphant, it sounded almost desperate, frantic. There it is. For anyone who's actually watched this unbelievably long video of me being silent and playing video games, you think you have a handle on what it is that this game does that so very, very few games even attempt to do. Like, much less succeed at it. This game does something that most games don't even try for nowadays. With a few exceptions. When did Orange take my turret? I thought he was dead. He's about to be. He's a little prick. Again, the shadow is repulsed, but still it follows us. All attempts at peace are met with nothing. This war has waged on far too long for we enemies to put aside our differences now. Recourse is a continued bloodshed. Death for death, blood for blood. We know that we live on borrowed time, but our fights seem so important while they're happening. Thank you. comes to this. Destruction, even with destruction so close at hand, we cannot put aside our petty trifles, our disputes, the war that we have come to love, to cherish, to need. We need this war. It defines us. It has become us. Earlier, I was silent out of respect for the story. Now I'm silent because I am tryharding so unbelievably hard right now. There aren't even words for how tryhard I am in this moment. Doesn't appear to be making very much difference. If that citadel in the top right falls to black, it's game over. There is no coming back from that. And I have exactly fuck all chance to stop him. GG. Thank you. try something different this time. Send some squadrons to start bothering those turrets. And see how they do. Kicked green out of the west half. Green has no troops left. Excellent. So very excellent. Northeast Citadel just fell. Can I take it? Maybe. Yes. Okay. Well, I'm sorry, Orange, but I'm gonna have to take your stuff. Yeah, it's just, I'm sorry, it's the way it's gotta, man. My lord. Black really, really wants that outpost. Teleporter, whatever. Okay, he left. Which means I can conquer this. Take that. Abandon that. That's fine. Half of me thinks I should just stop trying to take those inner towers, and the other half of me thinks, man, if I could just take those inner towers, this level would be easy. course, then this happens, and they get fucked, and that's GG. Of course, I can't withdraw them to anywhere. You know what? I'm just gonna go for it. I'm just gonna go for it. It's not gonna work. He's gonna recall all of his reinforcements, and my dudes are fucked. Withdraw. Hmm. 160 of the fleet made it out of that? That's surprising. Shit. Abandoned ship. I am really not a fan of this last level. It is... Even if you're doing everything right, it is hard. Maybe I should try and take more of these outlying planets. Reinforcements get decimated before they even get there because of the frickin' turrets! Just end up wasting more of my fleets than I do actually gaining anything. I want to win so badly. I've done it before. I've even done it on the hardest difficulty, I think. But... So here's what we're gonna do. We're going to leave my forward planets guarded, and we're just gonna go hell-bent for leather on... all of Green's shit. That's just, we're gonna take everything. There, are we good? Alright, now, I'm not gonna fuck around with the east half of the map this time, because I kind of feel like that was really just distracting me. So instead of that, gonna send a few boarding parties to take... That's not gonna work. Captured enough of the turrets to make a difference? Except now I'm at the population cap! Okay. So, let's send half of you guys down, and a third of you guys down. You guys, you all leave. They're all dead. What I've... Oh man, I've got three of those inner turrets now. That is a great thing. That is such a good thing. There are not words for how good a thing that is. Back up. Have the winning strategy right here. At this point, this is the point now where I go fuck over red and orange. It's like the hardest part about this specific map is the population cap really gets in the way here, like it doesn't do on any other level, like more than anywhere else. Actually, no, I'm gonna say, this is the only level in which the population cap just really, really gets on my nerves, because, like you saw, in order to actually defend any of those turrets, I had to hit the population cap just to have, like, even a rudimentary guard there. Let's balance out some of those guards, by the way, speaking of which. Thank you. I probably could have gone after that core much sooner. But fuck that. Fuck all of that. I want to get all the planets. I want to get my population cap up. And I want to fucking crush this. And they are defeated. Must undo the damage that we have done. This vile scourge must be sealed away forever. No cost too great, no sacrifice unfathomable. Return unto the void. Going to be honest, I did not remember that game being quite that long. I thought this was just going to be, oh, go play Solarmax for half an hour and burn through it. How long have I been recording for an hour and 47 minutes? Good lord. My gosh. Oh my god. I could have turned this into like its own miniseries, and I probably should have. In fact, I should probably just cut out, like, the bulk of the middle of that in most of that last ordeal where I just fuck up, but I don't know how to do that, so I'm sorry, but if you got this far into the video to even hear my apology, then that means you must have watched it all the way through, which, I don't know, maybe you're on a car trip and you wanted to just have this playing in the background for the cool music, or maybe you're playing some kind of Xbox game, you just wanted something to be going on the side, which I do that way too often. I'm rambling, it's late, I'm tired, so that is, I guess, my curtain calling for the night. Oh god, I've gotta be up at 10 o'clock. I need to shut up. But anyways, the thing that I loved about this game, and you might have noticed from what I said throughout, you'll notice that this game most certainly has a cohesive story. You start off alone, exploring the universe. You meet a rival faction, and a territory struggle ensues. You battle with them, escalating until you find fragments of a lost civilization. Great weapons, technological marvels, the like which you cannot reproduce on your own, only scavenge. You continue until you find a third faction, and a fourth, and with only so many planets to colonize, a war breaks out between everyone, each side equally matched, desperate to gain an advantage over the other. Every artifact you find increases your power, until you find one that brings about an end. With the darkness unleashed, It rages across the universe with savagery and speed and bloodlust unlike anything that mankind could reproduce or even understand. Everything comes to a culmination in one last battle, one final desperate attempt to seal this darkness away and claim true victory over the stars. And you will also notice that this game managed to tell that entire story, short though the summary was, without a single piece of the English language. No dialogue, no voiceovers, no narration, no subtitles. A narrative told entirely through the interactive experience. A story told through gameplay. It's the kind of thing Extra Credits did an episode on their channel at some point in the past talking about this aspiration that a video game could tell a story entirely through mechanics alone and without anything else. Tell some kind of compelling story entirely through narrative. And their example, you should go watch everything Extra Credits has done, by the way. If you like science and math and logic and you like to understand how things work, they explain how video games work. But their example of a game story told entirely through mechanics was Missile Command, I believe. And how you are... Actually, no, no. Go to Extra Credits channel, go look up their video of narrative told through mechanics, and listen to what they have to say. And then come back here and look. Look at this silly little flash game made by probably one man, put up for free on the internet, online, on this wonderful conglomeration of things that we call the internet. It accomplishes that lofty goal of telling a story entirely through mechanics. It leans on the musical score a little bit, but that's quite alright. If you were paying close attention through the entire thing, you can hear the changes in the music score. You have, like here in the menu screen, you have these lofty, peaceful overtones during the first few missions of exploration, but the score changes to something a little bit more violent, a little bit more passionate, during the middle missions when everything is war and everything is to be conquered. Then in the end, you hear the music score again changes to something more desperate, frantic, afraid, as you take a last bid to seal away the darkness. That's about all I have to say about this game, really. I want to see more things like this. I want to see games that successfully tell a story without any words. And believe me, I love books. I love to read. I love to have some deep, complex story with like twists and intrigue and all of that, but at the same time, there's a certain elegance to be admired in something this simplistic yet perfect. Wait, Steam Greenlight? What was this button here? Hold the phone. Is it gonna keep recording? It's still recording Firefox. Oh god, now you get to see how awful my internet is. Steam Greenlight. What was this greenlighted for? Actually, you know what? No, my curtain is calling. I need to get some sleep. I'm gonna go look at the Steam Greenlight and I'm gonna see what it is. I'll probably put a link down in the comments and see what this is about, but if this game got some kind of green light for a sequel to appear on Steam, I know exactly what my next $15 is going to be spent for. But I've said it, how many times have I said my outro phrase? At least two. I'm rambling. I'm going to go to sleep. Good night, everyone, anyone, if anyone managed to watch this entire 2-hour behemoth of a video, you deserve an award for perseverance, if nothing else. Good night.